Hi everybody, welcome to ThaiFact.com. I'm just heading home right now and I wanted to give you five quick tips on taking a taxi here in Bangkok. You'll take the taxis a lot here. They really are a great way to get around the city because you enjoy some air conditioning and they're actually relatively inexpensive, no matter what some people like to say. I'm gonna give you five quick tips on taking a taxi. The first tip is to look for a taxi that's available, and how you do that is you look for a red light that's mounted on the dash. Now this light means free, and if that light is lit, then that taxi is available. Second tip is to actually wave the taxi down. The Thais do it by waving down your hand like this. Some foreigners come here and they wave like this, but that actually means goodbye. So here's the taxi driver wondering why you're waving goodbye at him. So to do it properly here, you wave your hand down like this. Tip number three is, not every taxi driver is going to know every single nook and cranny and small soy in the city. There's actually no test or examination required to become a taxi driver, so they may not be too familiar with every aspect of the city. So to make sure that you get to where you're going and there's no unexpected, unintended routes, it's a really good idea to write your address down in Thai. Even better is when you get in the taxi, phone your destination and hand your phone to the taxi driver. That way he can talk to where you need to go and he knows exactly where to go and everyone is happy. Tip number four, if you lose something or forget something in the taxi, hope is not completely lost, a little bit lost, but not completely lost. There is a chance you are able to get it back. And how you do that is you phone the taxi hotline, which is 1164. If you phone that number and give them the taxi number that you were just in, they can make arrangements to contact that driver and usually to get your item back. Now, how you find your particular taxi number is you look on the door. And on the door, you see this little badge, and every taxi has one, and the badge number corresponds to the number of that taxi. So give them this number and usually offer a bit of a reward, and usually the driver will bring your item back. Last tip number five, is before you open the door, and I know all you cyclists will appreciate this one, is before you open the door, always look behind you and make sure there's not a motorcyclist coming. Because just because you've pulled up next to the sidewalk, don't assume that a motorcyclist might not try to sneak in between the taxi and the sidewalk. And if you open the door and a motorcyclist crashes into the door, you are going to be responsible for the damage to the taxi as well as the damage to the motorcycle. And trust me, that can get into the thousands of dollars very quickly. So before you open the door, always do a quick glance behind you to make sure there's not any oncoming motorcycle taxis. So there you go, five quick tips on how to take a taxi in Bangkok. I've got a special guest writer this week on my blog, and he actually has this really interesting website called Still Life in Moving Vehicles, where he documents many of the Buddhist artifacts and monuments that you see in many of the taxi drivers here. Many of the taxi drivers are a little bit superstitious, a little bit religious, and they believe that all these different monuments and drawings on the ceiling will bring them good luck and good customers. So he actually has spent the last 4 years photographing and documenting what each one of these little symbols mean to that respective driver. It's really a fascinating look into the Buddhist culture side of Thailand. So if you're interested in that, he's written a guest post on my blog talking about what he does, and he offers some more tips on taking a taxi in Bangkok. So check those out. Hopefully those five tips help you, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.